Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, hi, my name is Valentina, I'm a makeup lover and I like to test makeup products, and in today's video I'm going to test a new setting powder, and it's by Chanel, and I have this Le Beige Healthy Glow Sheer Powder. I have it on my skin right now, and I'm going to create this makeup look by using some of my favorite makeup products. So if you like what you see and want to find out more, then keep on watching. I already have my eyebrows on, and for my eyebrows I've used this Rare Beauty Brow Harmony Precision Pencil with this Benefit 24-Hour Brow Setter. This brow pencil by Rare Beauty is my favorite right now. I use this every day. It's very long lasting, I like the color, and it's very easy to use. And I don't reach for a brow setter for every day, but when I want my makeup to last very well, I like to set my eyebrows. And my favorite brow setter is this one by Benefit, the 24-Hour Brow Setter. And on my skin, I have just my regular moisturizer on, and I'm not going to use a primer because today I'll go out for a few hours and I don't really need my makeup to last all day and all night, just for a few hours. I want a very fresh makeup base and something more interesting on my eyes. And I'm going to use my favorite makeup products because when I go out, when I go somewhere, I like to use only the best makeup I have. These are the products I've used before on my channel, and I have a first impression video for everything. And for today, I have just one new makeup product to test, and it's a setting powder. And I'm going to start with my foundation. And for today, I'm going to use this one by Laura Mercier. This is Real Flawless Weightless Perfecting Foundation. I've used this foundation a lot in my last videos, but I have to say that this is my favorite foundation right now because I really like the finish of it, has a really nice natural finish and lasts all day. And I like to apply this foundation with my beauty blender. Next, I'll move on to my concealer, and for today, I'm going to use this one by Makeup Forever. This is the new HD Skin Concealer. I have a first impression video for this concealer, so if you want to check that video, I will link it down below. For now, I have to say that I really like this concealer. I use it every day, I like the finish of it, it's long lasting, so I want to use it today, and I also want to use it as my eyeshadow primer. And now I need to set everything in place with my powder. But for today, I have a new powder to test, and this is the only new makeup product I have for today's video. So in today's video, I'm going to test this powder by Chanel. This is Le Beige Healthy Glow Sheer Powder. I have this in the shade B10. This is how the box looks. And here is the powder, but this one comes with a little pouch, a velvet pouch. And this is how the packaging looks. The powder comes with this brush by Chanel and has a nice mirror in here. This is a very good quality mirror. And this is the powder. And I have this powder in the shade B10. It's the lightest shade. This one looks a little bit dark in the pan, so I'm very curious to see if this will be dark for me. Okay, this powder is very finely milled, feels very soft, and I think This blurs the texture a little bit, and I don't see any glitter particles in the powder. I was afraid that this might have glitter particles in it because it's a healthy glow sheer powder. So next I'm going to read a little bit about this powder from a Chanel website. So this powder is supposed to be easy to apply even without a mirror for a natural glow in all lighting. Its lightweight formula offers a blurring effect for a subtle satin finish that never creases, and the formula, which has no visible shimmer and never appears orange on the skin, provides buildable coverage and a natural look for every season. Its photo-adaptive complex ensures radiance and a healthy glow in any lighting. The Beige Healthy Glow Sheer Powder gives skin lasting comfort for up to 8 hours. And this powder was made in France and has a 18 months shelf life. I also want to mention that this has a very pretty and subtle smell to it. Nothing too intense, but this is a little bit scented, but the smell is gorgeous. I really like how this powder smells. So next I'll move on and apply this powder on my skin. I'm going to use it first on this side of my face because I want to see the difference between the two sides. And I'm going to apply it on this side with this brush because I want to see if this is good. Because if this is good, I could take this powder with me in my bag everywhere. But first I want to get rid of the creases. I don't know how to apply it on my under eyes with this brush. This is weird. Okay, this brush is really weird. I don't know how to apply my powder with this brush. It's also very hard to use this brush on the under eyes. So this is the side with the powder on. Okay, this brush is really weird, but the powder is very good. I'm very impressed. This side looks more airbrushed and blurred. I also like the color. I don't think this is making my foundation darker. And on this side, I'm going to apply the powder with my Zoeva brush. This is 106 for powder. Okay, this powder is very finely milled, it's sheer, but also gives some coverage. I feel like now my skin looks perfected and airbrushed. My pores are not emphasized and my skin looks matte but healthy. So for now I'm very impressed. I really like how this powder makes my skin look. But I want to give you my final impressions at the end of the video after I finish with my makeup. And next I'll move on to my bronzer. And for my bronzer, I'm going to use this one by Dior. This is Dior Forever Natural Bronze in color 4 Tan Bronze. For my blush, I'm going to use this one by Benefit in the shade Krista. And my favorite highlighter for when I go out is this one by Fenty Beauty. This is the Diamond Bomb How Many Carats. I have this highlighter in the travel size version and I still have a lot in here. This highlighter has the most gorgeous particles of shimmer. I like to use this all over my eyelids and also on my cheeks when I want a very intense highlighter. And next, I'll move on to my eyes, and for my eyeshadow palette today, I'm going to use this one by Natasha Denona. This is I Need a Nude Palette. This is a new eyeshadow palette by Natasha Denona, and I've used this eyeshadow palette for the first time in my last video. So if you wanna check that video, I'll link it down below, because I've swatched all of these colors on my hand, and I've used most of these colors on my eyes. And for today, I'm going to use a few colors. And for today, I'm going to use this color called Mesh in my crease and on my lower lash line. This is a really nice transition shade on my fair skin. Next, I'm going to use this Muse all over my eyelids. Next, I'm going to use this Tender and some on my lower lash line. Next, I'm going to apply eyeliner, and I'm going to use this one by Benefit. This is the Real Extreme Precision Liner. This is my favorite eyeliner right now. It's very good, waterproof, long-lasting. It's very easy to use. I like the tip. So if I have to recommend you one eyeliner right now, I highly recommend you this one by Benefit. And I'm going to use this Pat McGrath Labs Perma Gel Ultra Glide Eye Pencil in Extreme Black on my waterline. And on my inner corners, I'm going to apply this Mia. I'm going to apply my mascara off camera and something on my lips, and I'll be right back. And this is the finished makeup look. For my mascara, I've used this Dior Show Iconic Over Curl Mascara. I've used this mascara today because this one doesn't transfer on my under eyes, so this is very good. And on my lips, I have this lip liner by Makeup Forever. This is the Artist Color Pencil in color Endless Cacao. And for my lipstick, I've used this Huda Beauty Liquid Matte in the color Miss America. And now, final impressions for my new powder by Chanel, this Healthy Glow Sheer Powder. Let me show you how my skin looks up close. I have to say that I really like how my skin looks up close. My skin looks matte, but with a little bit of a glow, but I don't see any glitter particles on my skin. I like that my pores are not emphasized. My skin looks radiant and blurred. So for now, I really like this powder. I have to test it to see if this one will make my makeup last longer. I have oily skin, so I really need a good setting powder. So I'll use this powder again with other makeup products and test it. And I'll update you about everything in my next video. I would love to know from you guys if you like the finished makeup look, and please let me know what other makeup products would you like me to test next. But that's everything for today. I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you like it. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and also ring the bell to be notified when I upload. I post every week, so make sure to hit the notification bell. I hope you'll have a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!